Hey guys, Bratty Biker here. Hope you are doing well. A new motorcycle has come home, but I'm not gonna take this. This is not mine. I want you guys to guess what it is in the comment section below. My motorcycle is over there. It's a 1997 Yamaha RXD for all the new subscribers. Due to the floods caused to the rains, as you guys can see, the entire place is messed up. So the bike has been in hibernation mode for a long time now. There is not too much fuel sloshing around in the tank. Probably need to refuel her up soon. It's a good practice to shake your two-stroke motorcycle before a cold start, because as you guys know, oil is mixed with petrol, and when it is sitting like this for a long time, sometimes the oil can settle down below. So shaking it up will slosh the petrol inside the tank and, you know, mix it up again properly. I don't know how many kicks she's gonna take to start, but let us prime her up with some slow kicks, I guess. See that? She started right back up actually. Let's go. Man, it's been so long. See, the main road doesn't look like it's flooded at all. It's all due to my street. That is screwed up. See, this low areas, this is where the water is still hanging out. So we will still need a good gush of sunlight to clear it up. Yep. She's reaching reserve now. Okay, reached reserve at 17,314, yeah, almost 15 kilometers. 17,315 kilometers. I need to find a fuel station soon. I really wish the sun stays here for a few days at least, because like it's been rain after rain, man. Just insane. Like it's been so much rain that it's even, it's become impossible to track the damn thing, you know. So yeah, I mean, really hope the sun stays for some time, at least a week or so before the next rain start, because unfortunately another cyclone has formed. I mean, I know rains are good, you know, cyclones forming are good, it brings rainwater and stuff. Oh my god. Brings rainwater and stuff to the place, you know, for a city like Madras where there are no major river crossings for us to take water from. The rains are a good source, but I mean, come on man, the entire place is flooded, and I mean, we cannot ride these motorcycles, especially old motorcycles, when there is too much water, because rust can start appearing very quickly. Sometimes no matter how responsible you are, circumstances can just happen, man. Oh man, the bike is lagging. Don't tell me there is no fuel. Yeah, there is no fuel. Have to hold the clutch before I seize it up. Okay, now I have to. Ha! There is a filling station. Thank God. Haha, man, that bike died. There is a fuel station right here. Thank God. It's a very small walk from here. Just completely emptied my tank, I guess. Sir, oil ruka. Thank you, sir. Now we have that no helmet, no petrol rule, where if you arrive without the petrol, I mean, without the helmet and without the seat belt, they will not provide you with petrol. Or any fuel for that matter. Card irukka ji? Oru 4 liter podunga. Oil vandu 1 liter 25, 4 liter 100 ml podunga. ஹண்ட்ரட் எம்எல் சரி மூணு பேக்கெட் போட்டு யா ஆ 120 ml ஓகே இப்போ ஐ ரீச் நியூட்ரல் ஸோ சின்ஸ் தேர் இஸ் ஓன்லி த பேக்கெட் ஆக்சுவலி குட் திங் பிகாஸ் பேக்கெட்ஸ் ஆர் ஜென்ரலி அ லாட் மோர் யூ நோ க்ளீனர் தென் த டிஸ்பென்சர்ஸ் ஸோ லெட் மீ ஜஸ்ட் கெட் ஆன் த பைக் நவ ஸோ 120 ml 4 liters யா ஷூர் ஓ இப்படியே இது மேலே அப்படியே ஊற்றுருவீங்களா ஆ நல்லா இருக்கு இந்த ஐடியா ஆ அப்படியா ஆ வண்டி டேங்க் ஃபுல்லாக ட்ரை ஆகிடுது ரொம்ப தேங்க்ஸ் சார் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ்டாக இருக்கீங்க ஸோ சின்ஸ் த டேங்க் இஸ் ட்ரை வாட் தேர் டூயிங் இஸ் தேர் யூஸிங் த ஆயில் பேக்கெட் ஆன் த டாப் அண்ட் தென் ஃபில்லிங் ஃப்ரம் யூர் ஸோ இட் கெட்ஸ் மிக்ஸ் ப்ராப்பர்லி அண்ட் தென் கோஸ் டு த ஃபியூல் டேங்க் சின்ன ஒரு யூடியூப் சேனல் வச்சுருக்கேன் அதனால தான் உங்கள் பேர் சார் கமலக்கண்ணன் So we've used the Mac 2T. Mac is pretty good actually. It's a very thin 2T oil. I'd suggest that for running in engines. You know, if your engine is freshly rebuilt, then you can use Mac 2T. It's very thin because freshly built engines have very tight clearances because they're, you know, obviously they have to get run in. So at those tight clearances, thin oils will really help. Thank you, Ji. Let us hope she starts now. Okay. He started right up. Okay, let's fill up. Air ka? Ah. Okay. Sir, front 28. 28, back 32, sir. I don't seem to have some change. Okay, now we'll go. I think the main jet is blocked due to debris because only the pilot jet is activating because yeah when I open up the bike is not responding properly I don't know what happened see that yep the main jet is blocked most likely only the pilot and atomizer is working I think that the filter is overwhelmed. Like when it ran dry, all the debris must have been sucked into the filter and the filter might not have been able to filter out so much. So maybe some of them just went into the carburetor. So let me dismantle the carburetor and show you now if there is any dirt or debris inside of it. Hoping it's not too serious, but yeah, I mean, we never know.
After I finished the carburetor cleaning up job, I realized that I forgot to press the record button on my camera so that sucks the entire process couldn't be recorded so I'll just give you a small run through on the things that I have done here so the carburetor is clean now as you guys can see and it's a new fuel filter the same model another one and other things like the petcock or the fuel tank has been left untouched so this is the change and the bike is starting up and running very fine pulls very well no problems no acceleration or mileage problems running very well so what happened in my case is that somehow there is still some dirt or gunk in my fuel tank although the rust have been removed and although it has been cleaned another time but still some dirt or gunk is present I feel that internally it's falling apart so all the metal bits are falling into the petrol and it's making an entire mess this is what I think I'm not exactly sure So I'll need to clean the tank one more time
and I'm just not gonna leave this because I need a permanent solution or at least something long term. So I'm still researching on what I can do regarding this, and if I find a method or a way to get it done, I'll definitely make a video and share it on my YouTube channel so that it will help you guys if you're going through the same problem as me. So that is why I do not suggest you to run on reserve for too long, because generally you can expect some sort of dirt or debris inside your tank. It could have come through any way. If your fuel station does not have very pure fuel, if it is a little dirty during the process of loading or unloading the fuel, it can happen. So generally I do not suggest you to run too far on reserve. Once the bike hits reserve, start searching for a fuel station and quickly fill it up so that you will not face this problem. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you guys found this video useful. What next? Well, we'll be taking a delivery of a brand new motorcycle. Not mine, but my father's new motorcycle. And as you guys saw in the first clip of this video, do comment down below what you think the new motorcycle is. I will highlight the correct answer. And in the next video, we'll go and take the delivery of this motorcycle and I'll speak a bit about it. Thank you for watching, guys. If you like this video, please do leave a like below. Do share this video with your fellow two-strokers so that they also don't run into this problem like me. Do comment down your video suggestions and video requests. I shall put in my best efforts to get it done for you guys. Please do consider subscribing to the channel if you like this sort of two-stroke content. Keep the blue smoke alive. Bratty Baker signing off. Have a wonderful day.